Here is Danny, and today, seemingly professional file digger Temporial has posted a list of leaked weapons and gadgets on Reddit that might make its way into Battlefield 5 within the coming months. But of course, like always, just because it is in the files doesn't mean they will actually make it into the game. Grab yourself some drinks, since it's gonna be a pretty long video for once, at least for my channel standards. But without wasting any more time, let's start with the primary weapons, of which some guns even got an in-game description already. Like the M2 carbine, of which the description reads, "The M2 was the select fire variation of the iconic M1A1 carbine. US troops loved it due to its firepower, lightweight and small size." Then we got the Breda PG, which is a semi-auto rifle with a 600 rate of fire and 20 bullets, which seems to be a new assault spam fire weapon. Just what the game needed. Support seems to get the M1919A6MMG, with the in-game description that says, "The M1919 is mainly known as a 30-cal machine gun. A bipod and a carrying handle was added, which resulted in the A6 model. He also gets a S2-200MMG with the description, "The S2-200 was a magazine-fed machine gun originally banned by the Treaty of Versailles after World War I. Rejected by the German infantry, the Luftwaffe eventually adopted them for use in their aircraft, and the Madsen LMG, which was already seen in some of the pre-release trailers of Battlefield 5. But we cannot forget the Chow Chat either, which is even usable inside the single player and the co-op mission in Rotjeknor. Then there is the Lati Salaronta M26, which is coming out in 1 month. But due to a bug, I managed to play with it already and got gameplay of it on my channel right now. Link is of course in the description. Another gun that is already playable due to a bug is the Commando rifle. Video of course is in the description. I am predictable, I know. Another carbine is the M9128 con Troboncino, which is basically the Carcano rifle from Battlefield 1. For the SMGs, we got the MAB-38, which is a 600 RPM submachine gun. We also get the Sterling SMG, with the in-game description that says, "British Airborne and Special Operation Troops used a few samples of the Patriot SMG in 1944, but the well-liked gun didn't enter mass production until after the end of the war." And then there is also a Welkin. The Special Operations executives had many projects going on during the war. Among these was the Welkin, a submachine gun that would be easy to use and is cheap to produce. Only a few prototypes were made. We also might get the Lanchester SMG, which is a clone of the German MP28, made by Britain. We also seem to get Battlefield 1's M1917 Enfield, of which a dog tag is already visible in the menus. And of course the Shotgun shotgun, which also was shown off in the pre-release gameplay, but hasn't made it into the game yet. Now for the sidearms. We start off with the Wellrod, which was a single fire silenced pistol, with the description, "The British developed the Wellrod pistol to be as quiet as possible. It was bolt operated and magazine fed, at only 73 decibel. It was about as loud as a present day car. But if you want more louder pistols, the Model 27 is for you, a nice revolver. Or the PPK of course. And there is an interesting silenced variant mentioned as well. And now onto the gadgets. And me butchering the next name. The Panzerbusse 39, a German anti-material rifle. And to counter that out, the Allies got the Boys AT rifle, which was commonly misnamed the Boyes AT rifle. This one might be fun as well, the Goliath Mine, a remote controlled explosive vehicle. Maybe it's good for the people who are missing their rubber bot from Battlefield 4 or something. It can turn into total cheese or completely useless. Time will tell. There might also be an RMN-50 frag launcher coming. However, Temporial mentioned that it seems to be used more as a mortar instead of a noob tube, like the name suggests. And I just pushed a thing away. Yes, I keep it in. It seems to be linked to the 5v5 mode named Grind. Then there is the Type 89 knee mortar, which was widely used during the Pacific Theater. And with the upcoming Americans, we get of course the classic M1A1 bazooka. But we are not done yet. DICE thought there aren't enough explosives in the game already, so they will maybe add the Panzerschreck 2 and a buff Surrat, where you drug yourself or a teammate to enhance your capabilities, whatever that means. There also seems to be some heavily specialized gadgets that seem to be intended for the 5v5 competitive mode, namely the TN-17 radio jammer, a breaching charge, a shaped charge, tripwire smoke, and a Fliegerfaust, which seems to be anti-air. We also seem to be getting all of the carbines and machine pistols from Battlefield 1, like the Frommer Stop Auto, or like I like to call it, the G18 pistol. But also a model Astra 903 with a crazy 1100 rate of fire, comparable to the K10 of Battlefield Hardline. We also get the machine pistol M1912, the P08 artillery Luger, the C69 carbine, and the MLE 1903 extended. There's also mentions found for multiple melee weapons. Let's go through them quickly. We get a lever pipe, Verborn Sykes, Volmskirmjäger Switchblade, stupid name, the EGW Survival Knife, the M2 Paratrooper Switchblade, a Saber, the French Nail, the US Trans Knife, the Arditi Dagger, which I still haven't unlocked in Battlefield 1, the Scout and Russian Combat Knife, the Barbed Baseball Bat, which was already shown on Reddit accidentally, a folding shovel, the French hunting knife, a quartermaster knife, the machete, a fire axe, fire rake, and fire iron, and a escape axe, which was given to pilots during the war, a Sith, which is usually shown with the Grim Reaper, so no idea if it's for Easter eggs or something, a mountain axe, and some level specific items like a wooden plank and a broken bottle. Oh, and as last, the almighty M80 firecracker. Initially meant to be part of Battlefield 5 as one of the archetypes, it is now a distraction item in the 5v5 competitive mode. That was a lot, and that is about it. You can watch yesterday's video about the upcoming vehicles and tomorrow's video for new customization stuff. But anyway, big shout out to Temporial and my Patreons. This is Danny, and I see you on the battlefields.